So everybody, welcome to Accounts Receivable. This is part two, the balance sheet presentation, or the end goal of what we're going to be doing here. So our goal on the balance sheet is to show our investors, remember, when we are preparing financial statements, we are doing so for the investors. That is the objective of financial reporting. If the investors see a number on the balance sheet, that needs to really tell them that this is what we expect to collect. And this is very important for accounts receivable. Let's take a look here at Meta Platforms, aka Facebook. Right over here, when I look at Meta Platforms on its balance sheet, what you're going to see here is you're going to see accounts receivable, net of allowances of 110 and 114 as of September 30th, 2021 and December 31st, 2020. And AR net of the allowance was $12 billion as of September 30th, 2021. And as of December 31st, 2020, it was $11.3 billion. So as we look at this, what does this net mean? Well, if I look at what the net means, and this is really what they're doing here, the total amount of the accounts receivable net was $12,088,000,000. And this goes back to one of our earlier conversations from adjusting journal entries when we were looking at depreciation expense and that other contra asset account, accumulated depreciation. When we're looking over here at this is what we call our allowance for doubtful accounts. When you see this over here, net of allowances, this is an allowance for doubtful accounts. So when we're showing accounts receivable on the balance sheet, we need to be showing it at, well, what do we expect to collect? Facebook had $12,198,000,000 of accounts receivable, but it doesn't expect to collect $110 million of this amount. It expects to ultimately collect $12,088,000,000. So when we are showing to our investors what we're on our balance sheet, we have to show accounts receivable less what we do not expect to collect. And what exactly is the ADA? This is going to be a contra asset account. It's going to have a credit balance. Remember, contra asset accounts will have a credit balance because over here, it's going to be reducing the amount of the asset. We're going to have accounts receivable, which is an asset that will have a debit balance. Our allowance for doubtful accounts will have a credit balance. So really, really important. It's going to show that amount of the AR that we do not expect to collect. And so again, this ADA is going to help us show accounts receivable net. So again, our end goal is to show our investors, hey, this is what I expect to collect of my accounts receivable. And so that's it. We're going to use something called the allowance for doubtful accounts. It is a contra asset account. And when we show accounts receivable on our balance sheet, we're going to show it net of the allowance, very similar to Meta Platforms or of Facebook. So with that all being said, I want to thank you for joining me here today. Please leave any kind of questions you might have below, and really appreciate you liking and subscribing to the videos. Have a great day.